Also here tonight, Loveland voters will soon decide whether or not they want to get rid of taxes on grocery sales.
It's a measure on the November ballot that could have some big impacts on money impacts, I should say, on both sides of the decision. FOX31's Nicole Fierro went to Loveland to dig into these details.
Yeah, we came here to dive into Proposition 300 on the November ballot. It's letting voters decide if they want to keep paying that 3% sales tax on their groceries. Walking down the aisles, picking out the essentials, necessary trips to the grocery store, now Loveland voters have a decision to make.
Ballot question 300, if passed, would remove food for home consumption from our sales tax base.
3% sales taxes, the rate on food for home consumption, might sound good for your household budget, but there's a real cost.
So that would be a $10.5 million reduction in 2024, and that would persist every year after that.
Loveland's chief financial officer, Brian Waldies, talking about a reduction specifically to the city's general fund. He says as a whole, the general fund's budget is about $130 million, including capital.
If you take $10.5 million out of that equation, we would have to seek to reduce expenses or change our programs or service levels in some way to make that up. It's used for everything from, you know, public safety to plowing the streets, the rec center and library.
To say that there's going to be a loss is just looking at one side of the equation.
Loveland resident George Gark lives with Let Us Vote Loveland, a group of voters who advocate for the initiative, sees another side.
Not just the one side that the sky might be falling and the parks will be closed down. I don't think that's going to happen. That's been used before.
He calls the 3% tax unfair to struggling families.
You know what? It hurts people. It's a regressive tax.
While neighboring cities charge the tax, Garcliffe's knows other cities in our state don't.
And they find ways to make it. So, and, you know, it's, I think with the creative folks that we've got in the city, they can find ways to make this work and engage with the public.
Engaging, the bottom of it all, for whoever you ask.
I would like them to be aware of the issue, to see both sides of it.
No matter what the community decides, we'll be ready to administer it. We just want people to have information.
On November 7th, the Loveland voters will decide what happens, and if it is eliminated, that tax, that will go into effect on January 1st. In Loveland, Nicole Fierro, Fox 31. All right.